Okay, so here's ChatGPT. I've got it running. I hit the icon right here by the microphone symbol. I'm gonna wait for the icon to change. There it is, it's running. Hey, can you speak to me in Thai? It tends to speak very fast, so can you speak slower? Cool. When you have the paid version, as of October 4, 2024, the paid version gets you 30 to 45 minutes of advanced voice time. Unfortunately, the free versions, the free users as of now, cannot use the advanced voice feature. But in true ChatGPT OpenAI fashion, what's going to happen is they let the paid people use it for a couple weeks or maybe a month or so, a couple weeks. And then they will trickle down usage to the free users. We hit the icon in the bottom right corner. I can chat to it in Thai, in English, or whatever. Hi, can you pretend to be a Thai police officer? Speak to me in Thai, and I will speak in Thai as well. ผมไม่รู้ไม่ผมอยากไปเทอร์มินอล 21ยินดีต้อนรับสู่กรุงเทพนะครับสำหรับการเดินทางไปเทอร์มินอล 21คุณสามารถใช้รถไฟฟ้า BTS
ไปลงที่สถานีอโศกได้เลยจากนั้นเดินเชื่อมเข้าห้างได้สะดวกมากครับ
เพียงบอกคนขับว่าไปเทอร์มินอล 21แถวแยกอโศกเขาจะพาคุณไปถึงหน้าห้างเลยผมไม่ชอบนั่งแท็กซี่เลยอ๋อเข้าใจแล้วครับถ้าอย่างนั้นให้ลองใช้บริการรถร่วมแอปพลิเคชันดูไหมครับเช่น Grab หรือ Bolt คุณสามารถเรียกรถง่ายๆผ่านแอปบนมือถือครับ
And then when you want to mute the app, so you want to mute the microphone going in, you could actually click that icon to either close it or mute it. So you can see that with voice, if you're a Thai language student, you can use this as a kind of like a, almost like a private tutor or a language buddy. So this is a term that having a language buddy is just someone that you could talk back and forth with. And they're not really a tutor in the sense that they're teaching you words and they're teaching you grammar. But what you're getting is the repetition and just being comfortable in listening and comfortable in speaking. So just to give you an idea. Hi, pretend to be a Thai nurse at a Thai hospital. Speak to me in Thai and I will respond in Thai.
สวัสดีครับวันนี้มีปวดหัวนิดหน่อยแล้วก็มีท้องเสียครับไม่เป็นไรนะคะเดี๋ยวพี่จะวัดความดันแล้วก็ให้ยาแก้ปวดศีรษะและแก่ท้องเสียนะคะเมื่อวานผมกินข้าวผัดกุ้งแล้วก็กินเพปซี่แล้วก็กินแอลกอฮอล์3แก้ว
เข้าใจแล้วค่ะอาหารกับเครื่องดื่มที่ทานอาจเป็นสาเหตุทำให้มีอาการปวดหัวและท้องเสียพี่จะแนะนำให้ดื่มน้ำเยอะๆพักผ่อนให้เพียงพอแล้วก็งดอาหารรสจัดและเครื่องดื่มแอลกอฮอล์ไปก่อนนะคะ
โอเคขอบคุณครับ Okay, so basically I had to pretend to be a nurse at a hospital. I told it that I have diarrhea and also I have a headache, and that came from I ate pork fried rice somewhere, and she's saying that drink a lot of water, rest, etc. So that's actually pretty good. And also what's great about this is it's not judgmental, so it's very supportive, but you could actually tell it to be strict and tell it to grade you. So if I speak wrong, if I use the wrong tones, etc. You could also have it do a Thai grammar lesson. So just as a last thing before we go. Hi, act as a Thai language teacher and explain to me the differences between English when we're talking about feeling sick or having stomach pain. So something like if I have diarrhea or I have a headache, how would I say that in Thai, and what's the difference between that and English?
Sure. In Thai, when we talk about feeling sick, we use phrases like buoy, bi boy, for sick, and mi akan, for having symptoms. For specific issues like diarrhea and headache, we say tong sia, for diarrhea, and buot hua, for headache. The structure in Thai tends to be straightforward, focusing on the verb or adjective first, followed by details. Unlike English,
for tong sia, is there a less formal, more street level, or more common way of saying tong sia?
Yes, in informal or casual speech, people often say tong ruang, for diarrhea. It's a bit more colloquial, but widely understood.
And what would be a very formal way of saying it?
In very formal or medical contexts, you might hear itsakara ruang, which directly refers to acute diarrhea. This term is more likely to be used by healthcare professionals.
So that's a very common way of how I've been using the advanced voice feature, is asking it, role-playing, pretend to be a nurse, pretend to be a police officer, pretend to be a newscaster, and then dialing up the formality, lowering the formality, you know, pick out the five vocabulary words from the conversation and give me sentences for all of them. So we'll be doing more videos about that in the future, but this was a quick introduction